Infertility. Infertility is defined as the inability to conceive a child after 1 year of regular sexual intercourse, unprotected by contraception. Secondary infertility is the inability to conceive after a previous pregnancy. Many people take the ability to conceive and produce a child for granted, but infertility affects more than 6 million Americans, or 15% of reproductive age population. Infertility is a widespread problem that has emotional, social, and economic impacts on couples. Infertility affects relationships, leads to tension and anger between partners, and can result in severe sexual dysfunction and breakdown of the relationship. Reproduction requires the interaction of the female and male reproductive tracts, which involves 1. The release of normal preovulatory oocytes, 2. The production of adequate spermatozoa, 3. The normal transport of these gametes to the ambulatory portion of the fallopian tube, and 4. The subsequent transport of the cleaving embryo into the endometrial cavity for implantation and fetal development. Multiple known and unknown factors affect fertility. Female factor infertility is detected in about 40% of cases. Male factor infertility is also in about 40% of cases. The remaining 20% fall into a category of combined, meaning both male and female factors, or unexplained infertility. In women, ovarian dysfunction and tubal pelvic pathology are the primary contributing factors to infertility. Risk factors for infertility in women include being under or overweight, hormonal imbalances, uterine fibroids, tubal blockages, cervical stenosis, reduced oocyte quality, chromosomal abnormalities, congenital anomalies of the uterus, immune system disorders, chronic illnesses such as diabetes, thyroid disease, or asthma, sexually transmitted infections, an age older than 27, endometriosis, Turner syndrome, a history of pelvic inflammatory disease, smoking and alcohol consumption, multiple miscarriages, exposure to chemotherapeutic agents, and psychological distress. Risk factors for infertility in men include exposure to toxic substances, cigarette or marijuana smoke, heavy alcohol consumption, use of certain prescription drugs for psoriasis or ulcers, exposure of the genitals to high temperatures such as hot tubs or saunas, a hernia repair, obesity that may be associated with decreased sperm quality, Cushing syndrome, frequent long-distance cycling or running, sexually transmitted infections, undescended testes called cryptocortism, or mumps that occur after puberty. The majority of infertility cases are treated with drugs or surgery. Various ovulation enhancement drugs and timed intercourse may be used for women with ovulatory problems. The woman should understand a drug's benefits and side effects before consenting to take it. Depending on the type of drug used and the dosage, some women may experience multiple births. If the woman's reproductive organs are damaged, surgery can be done to repair them. Still, other couples might opt for the high-tech approaches of artificial insemination, in vitro fertilization, and egg donation, or they may contract for a gestational carrier or surrogate. Home ovulation predictor kits may help. Home ovulation predictor kits contain monoclonal antibodies specific for luteinizing hormone and the use of ELISA tests to determine the amount of luteinizing hormone, or LH, present in the urine. A significant color change from baseline indicates the LH surge and presumably the most fertile day of the month for women. There is also a clomiphene citrate challenge test, which is used to assess a woman's ovarian reserve, or put more simply, the ability of her eggs to become fertilized. Follicle-stimulating hormone levels, or FSH levels, are drawn on cycle day 3 and on cycle day 10 after the woman takes 100 milligrams of clomiphene citrate on cycle days 5 through 9. If the FSH level is greater than 15, the result is considered abnormal and the likelihood of conception with her own eggs remains very low. Another method, hysterosalpingography, 3 to 10 milliliters of an opaque contrast medium is slowly injected through a catheter into the endocervical canal so that the uterus and tubes can be visualized during fluoroscopy and radiography. If the fallopian tubes are patent, the dye will descend upward to distend the uterus and the tubes and will spill out into the peritoneal cavity. A laparoscopy can also be used early in the menstrual cycle. It is not part of the routine infertility evaluation, but it is used when abnormalities are found on ultrasound or using the hysterosalpingogram. Because of the added risks of surgery, the need for anesthesia, and the operative costs, laparoscopy is only used when it is clearly indicated. During this procedure, an endoscope is inserted through a small incision in the anterior abdominal wall. Visualization of the peritoneal cavity in an infertile woman may reveal endometriosis, pelvic adhesions, tubal occlusions, fibroids, or polycystic ovaries. Thank you for watching.